Hi. So I have something that I want to talk about. I think this is pretty funny. Like my new shirt. Peace. Isn't that cool? I got it when I was in Sedona at my favorite thrift store. I was working and it was slow. I wasn't working. I was working online, but I wasn't, you know, like getting any calls. So I said to Spirit, what am I supposed to do? What do you want me to do? And I got very clearly, walk away. So I thought, okay. And they said, and then I thought, well, walk away from what? What am I walking away from? Because, you know, we got to be careful when we get messages from Spirit that we are understanding what they're saying, what they're applying to. Because if we ask questions, you know, there's a lot of different things that we have asked Spirit for guidance in, right? And so if they give us an answer, we need to make sure that we're understanding the message that is being answered, right? So I said, okay, well, what is it that I'm supposed to walk away from? Because I had a few things that I was thinking about. And what I got was, am I supposed to walk away from this job? Am I supposed to walk away from the situation? Am I supposed to walk away from this house, this area? You know, I had a lot of questions in my mind. And so I asked for another card, and the next card I got was connect with nature. So walk away, connect with nature. And I was thinking, you know, when it's slow for me at work, I go out on the water or I go for a walk. And I thought, okay, I'm going to go for a walk because I'm trying to get my body back, you know, back, my Sedona body back. After winter and after all the holidays, you know, it's everything. Everybody kind of gets in, you know, the place where they got to get their body back and bust it back in shape. So I got to turn around and see if this is even running. Yes. So I'm just about to head out and my landlord goes, where are you going? And I said, I'm going to go for a walk. And he goes, no, it's hotter than hell. He goes, go on the lake. And I said, yeah, but Spirit said to walk. And he says, Sherry, go row. And I said, no, I want to get the back of my ass in shape. It's the back of my ass I want to get in shape and the back of my thighs. And Spirit said to walk. And he says, and then he says, did they say to walk or what did they say? And I said, walk away. He says, okay, well, and I thought, you're right. Walk away from the work right now. Walk away from that and go connect with nature. And he says, I said, okay, I'm going to ask you one more time because I had my ankle weights on, right? I love these ankle weights. They keep me grounded, by the way. They keep me grounded, which is totally what I need because I live in Rapunzel's castle, right? I live, and then when I, and exercise, I generally come out and I'm on the water, so I'm not grounded. So I've bought these ankle weights in Sedona and I love them. I wear them in the house. I wear them everywhere. They literally, it's like a, not only is it good for when I go for walks because they add extra weight on my legs as I'm walking, but they remind me to keep my feet grounded. What happened? Oh, it's still going. I pushed a little thing and it moved. Keep myself grounded. And it's like, it's visualization, right? And this is not only just visualization, but I can feel it, which is another message. Talks about, I said, nothing is as it seems. And my friend said, and everything is not as it seems. And another person said, then create it or make it be what you want it to be. And I said, oh, I am. I am visualizing it and I'm feeling it the way I want it to be. I'm feeling it into existence, my desires, right? So when I have these ankle weights on me, I feel myself grounded. So I am grounding myself. It's a reminder, keep yourself grounded, Sherry, because a lot of times I'm up in spirit. I'm in my head too much, and I'm connecting so high with my spiritual, with the fifth dimension that I have to live in this reality, right? So there's that message. So I say to him, okay, you know, I'm standing there, I'm all ready to go, and I said, is it really hot? Because I don't like the heat, you know, and I'm not comfortable with my arms right now, so I always like wear a little sweater to cover them up. Another message, self-love. Who am I trying to impress? Because I'm really not trying to impress anybody out there, but I'm always like trying to cover up parts of myself. I will show you. I'm not thrilled with my arms right now. I want them to be more fit, you know, more firm and in shape. Working on it, you know. But so I said, okay, one more time. I'm standing there. I got my leg weights on. And I said, do I go for a walk or do I go on the canoe? And he says, well, I just say for you to go on the canoe. And he kept pushing me. He kept saying, you know, your canoe's lonely, which is a personal message because my canoe represents my my twin soul. And he's lonely, your canoe's lonely. And he says, you know, you can go for a walk anytime. You know, you go in the rain, you go at night, you go all the time. He goes, but you can only go on the water when the water's calm. And he says, and right now there's no wind, the water is calm. And he says, go out and enjoy yourself. So I thought, you're right. So I switched my leggings and I put on my short kind of leggings, right? And I took the sweater off. I said, God, Sherry, you're gonna go out there, it's sunshine, you know. Who are you trying to impress? Be comfortable, you don't have to wear a sweater. So I get down to my canoe and look at my canoe. The bottom of my canoe is got water in it from the rain. So there's been water, emotion expressed in my life, and it's filled up my canoe a little bit. It's too heavy for me to dump out by myself, so I have to ask Spirit to help me release it. My friend Yoris talked to me this morning, and he's brilliant, and was talking to me about a completely different situation, but the analogy, I looked at it symbolically, and it was talking about releasing in small amounts, but also eating in small amounts, which was a message for me as far as my diet goes. Eating in little bits and expressing in little bits, right? If you eat a little bit all day long, it helps your body. It's more balanced and regular instead of waiting, eating a lot, your stomach blows up, and then you have a difficult time getting rid of it. It's the same thing as far as, for me, as far as when I go to teach. You know, I'm wordy, and it's good to do these videos for people because a lot of times people have a difficult time reading. You know, if they're dyslexic or if they have a hard time reading through a long or keeping their focus, if I put these big long messages out or I send a big long message or I try to communicate a big long email, it's too much for somebody to assimilate. So give it in little doses, less words with more power behind it, right? Or else do a video. And it all works together. So I come down here and it's hot. It is hot. It's way hotter than I want it to be. I would prefer to be in the mountains. My girlfriend just got back from Iowa, and she drove through Colorado, which I want to go to, and Utah, which I have to go to. And she got back to, she said she got to Las Vegas, and it was like 74 degrees. And she's like, oh, it's warm, and it feels so good. And I was thinking, and she says, and we just came from like 20s and 30s. And I'm thinking, man, I'd rather go that way. I'd rather go where it's cooler. But why did I bring that up? So, because I'm down here without a sweater on. I'm getting a little bit of vitamin D, which is really, really good for us. You know, if you're feeling down, if you're feeling depressed, if you're feeling kind of in a funk, you're supposed to go and face the sun. Another personal message, the divine masculine. Put your face to the sun and absorb the energy from the sun. The vitamin D, it's good for you in small doses. Everything in small doses, everything in balance, right? So I'm laughing about this canoe because I switched to my short leggings. I had longer ones on, and I had my tennis shoes on, and I had my ankle weights on, and I took them all off, and now I've got, and I thought, okay, well, my canoe's got a little bit of water in it, but it's not going to sink me. And actually, with a little bit of water in it, it kind of weights the bottom down a bit, because this is a really tippy canoe. So it's okay to have a little bit of water, a little bit of emotion in it, but it's down around my feet. So it's releasing, which is good. It's releasing. But there's something else I wanted to talk to you guys about while I have you. I posted something. I thought it was pretty funny, and it just kind of clicked in my head. I don't know why I did it. And because I heard the on the radio they were talking about a premiere. You know, it's coming, and so I posted on Facebook. I'm going on a date this Friday. I've waited a long time for this one. I'm really excited. And everybody knows I don't date. I don't go out with anybody, right? Because I'm in love with my twin soul, and he's not around. So I just posted that, and I left it, and I walked away. And I meant to go back and add something, but I got waylaid by my landlord, you know, who's talking to me, and funny, he said he had a couple of wind chimes for me that they don't work down below where he is, and up where I am there's more wind and you can hear the music, which is up in spirit. I love that. Up in spirit, when you're up higher, you can hear the music when you connect to your higher self. I love that. I just popped in anyway. So I left, and I knew everyone was going to be like, oh my God, who are you going on with? I have so many personal messages right now, text messages from people. Who are you going on a date with? Oh my God, you haven't said anything. Who are you going on a date with? So I thought, okay, you know, I'm not going to torture everybody. So I went back and I put, it's kind of like a group date, actually. You know, there's probably a million other women that are going to be going. I'm going to be going to experience a very, exciting and sensuous experience at 50 Shades Darker. I'm gonna go to the movies because I've been waiting for this one to come out for a long time. And I will tell you, this is not a girl who reads romance novels. I don't watch porn. I'd rather make my own. I'm not into that whole, it's not my deal. But when 50 Shades of Grey came out, I was told by Spirit to go watch it because there were messages in it for me, and there were huge messages. I'm sure that I was the only girl in the theater who was taking notes during 50 Shades of Grey. And I started to read the book, and I'm so busy, you know, my mind's always going, that I can't, now that's another message, I can't keep focused on a book. So my messages, these big long emails that I would post or whatever, you can't keep focused when there's such a large amount to absorb, right? So I thought, you know, oh, the movie's coming out. So the movie's coming out on Friday and I'm gonna go see it. And I'm telling you, I know what's coming. I've already seen the whole movie anyway. I saw it 3 years ago, laid out, because it's my life. And but there's certain things that I don't know. So my message to you guys is, if you don't read to the end, you don't know the end of the story. Don't hang up a story until you finish it, until you go all the way to the end. You read that message, oh, I'm going on a date, I'm really excited. And you're like, oh my God, she's going on a date? No, read down further, read the messages, read the comments. It changes the story. Just like this morning, I posted a post, my friend Yoris posted about a little boy who had he was called the bad boy in school. He was a difficult child, labeled as a difficult child. And he couldn't pay attention, and the other kids, they went outside at recess and he was found at his desk crying because he felt like he was not included. He was ostracized by the other kids. And he was drawing on the blackboard. Apparently he's a very good artist. He likes to draw undersea creatures. And so his teacher made him a deal. Now, that's all I saw was that, right? So I posted that and I thought, wow, I love that little boy. I love that little boy because I do love that little boy. That little boy who's been misunderstood. That little boy who's been ostracized by others because he's different. I see his differences as brilliant because I'm different like him. And I love that little boy. And that was the message that I got. But then when I went to share it, I realized, oh my God, there's two more things underneath that I didn't see underneath the surface. And so I went back and I reposted it. And I said, you know, at first I only saw what was on the surface. I didn't realize that there was more hidden underneath that I needed to look into. I needed to look deeper and see what was in there, because there was more of a message. Well, the teacher made him a deal. And she said, if you do your work, if you promise to come to class and do your work, I will let you draw, continue, keep this drawing up, and you can continue, at least recess, you can continue doing your drawings. And so he was excited about that. He came to class, he was excited about coming to class, and he was learning, and he was able to express himself. Because he wasn't able to express himself in other ways. This way he could express himself through drawing. And he had this beautiful, he was so incredibly talented, but he never felt understood or never felt like anyone listened to him. And so as he was able to express himself and felt like he was being heard, he started getting along better with the kids in class and everything improved, right? And I know what the message is to this, and it's brilliant and I love it. And it was a message to myself in understanding what was going on underneath the surface. Things are not always as they appear. So it's like you can sit there and you can be in a movie like, okay, I've watched 50 Shades of Grey and I started to read the other one, and you could skip ahead even, right, and read the ending of it. But if you don't see what's in the middle, you don't know why. You don't know what the impetus is for certain things. And also a lot of times you may think, oh, I already know this. It's the same old story, I've seen it a million times. As in a relationship with somebody else, or, you know, I've experienced the same thing before with other people. But if you don't read it all the way to the end, you don't know the story, because it's not the same person, it's not the same time. And even if it is the same person, time has changed and they have changed and the story has changed, right? So all of those things. And I'm sure that when I gotta turn around because I'm getting blind, the sun is blinding me. I'm sure I'll find out more messages myself when I go to hear this, when I go to edit this later to put it up. Especially about the water in at my feet. Team effort, you know. Oh, and there's a spider. There's a spider that's in the nest here, and he doesn't want to get... Here, babe. Oops. Uh-oh, see? He doesn't want to get into the water, so he's got his little nest up here. Now, the spider is, we create our own reality. And, oh, there's a pair of them. And together, they're working as part of a team. Now, that's what I was going to say a second ago. I can't lift this canoe out of the water by myself. It's too heavy. So I have to have somebody help me. So you can't be an island, Batman. Remember Lego Batman? He doesn't have a lot of friends. And Robin, she just wants to be, all she wants is to work with Batman, but he works alone. I work alone. He's the lone wolf. But he has to learn that he has to be a part of a team, and that's how you get stuff done. So even these two little spiders, they're creating their own web, right? Every day. Do you know that a spider creates his web? And in the morning, they tear it down and they start again. They recreate every single day. So they're creating. I got to make sure that the other little guy didn't drown. Where did he go? He's not in the water. No, he's not. I'm sure there's going to be more things that come out, but these are the things that are coming out right now. And I'm now going to row across this beautiful lake that's very, very calm, and I'm going to go to the tunnel, to my favorite place. And I'll probably get a little bit of a tan on my arm, which is good. I don't want a lot, but a little bit is good because I feel pasty white and I need to get out in this weather. And when I get back to work, my energy will have changed because often, you know, that's all we need to do is shift our energy. Hold on, I gotta haul us out of here. All we have to do is, you know, shift things around a little bit, you know? Maybe things aren't working well at work. Why are things not working well at work? Well, I don't know, maybe your energy is stagnant. Maybe it's you. It is definitely you because our energy changes things. Also, I gotta tell you something right now. I'm sitting in the front of this canoe, okay? Look at where I'm at. I normally sit back there and I row from behind. This is a lot faster at the front of the canoe. I'm moving quicker through here. Now, at other times, it's easier for me from behind to get my way through the water. But right now, I'm able to move pretty quickly at the front of the canoe. I like that. So, well, maybe it's when you're by yourself, you're at the front of the canoe. And maybe when there's somebody else with you, one's in the front, one's in the back. And I gotta tell you, this would be a lot easier
if I had a partner. We'd go through the water a lot quicker. But right now I need to work out. I need to work out my arms. So I'm going to go to the back of the canoe and work myself out. That's it. Those are my messages. I hope you guys got something cool from it. I definitely did. As I talk things out, I hear my own messages as I go along. So we'll talk again soon. Peace, love, and light.